think we're all in the middle of it. I don't think there's anyone that's not involved in conservation in somehow or shouldn't be involved in conservation somehow. I think like this last week, led by Greta, you know, the world's children are striking. You know, I think there's an emergency that we are. It's a race against time, and one in which we are losing. Everyone knows it. There's no excuse for not knowing that. And I think the most troubling part of it is that I don't believe that there's anybody in this world that can deny science, undeniable science and facts. Science and facts that has been around for the last 30, maybe 40 years, and it's only getting stronger and stronger. I don't understand how anyone in this world, whoever we are, you, us, children, leaders, whoever it is, no one can deny science. Otherwise, we live in a very, very troubling world.
And just sitting.
I don't know, I've been coming, how long have we known each other? 15 years? 15 years. I've been coming here. It's a sense of escapism, a real sense of purpose. I'm able to come down here. I've been learning from this man for the last 15 years. Him and a bunch of other individuals that he's introduced me to, and they're friends. I have some of my closest friends here over the years, and I came here when I was 97, 98, straight after my mum died. So it was a nice place to get away from it all. But now I feel deeply connected to this place and to Africa. And I think, look, what we're seeing here in Africa, actually we're seeing all around the world. More and more people are being brought up, especially the younger generation, being brought up in concrete jungles, in cities, which is being inevitably meaning that you're becoming more and more disconnected with nature. And there's this symbiotic relationship that some people are trying to say, well, you know, animals are taking the place of humans, we should be pushing in and taking over. It doesn't work like that.